Hey Premiere Pros, it's Paul Murphy here, and today I'm going to show you how to reveal text with shapes. Okay, so today I'm going to show you the steps that I use to create these motion graphics templates, which are available for purchase on my website. So the first thing we need to do is to add a new graphic clip with some text inside of it. So I'm going to go over to my Essential Graphics panel and choose New Text. And I'll just type inside of that the Premiere Pro, and then I'll center it in the screen using these alignment buttons. And then the next thing we want to do is to add the rectangle that is going to wipe across this text. So to do that, I'm just going to choose New Layer and Rectangle. And if I go and select my selection tool, what I want to make sure is that this anchor point here is on the right side of the shape. So I'm going to click and drag this across. Now, if you find that you're not snapping to the edge of the shape, you can just hold down the Command or Control key and that will turn on snapping. I'll go and click and drag the left side of this so I make it a narrow line like that. And then I'll move it to the starting position of the animation, so to the right side of the word. And then to be organized, I'm going to click the name of this and I'll rename it Rectangle. And then the next thing I need to do is to create another rectangle that's like a mask that covers up the text. And to do that, here's a little trick for you. To duplicate a layer in the Essential Graphics panel, the shortcut key is Shift, Command or Control, and forward slash. And I'll just click the name of this layer here and I'll rename this Mask. And down the very bottom here, I'm going to turn on Mask with Shape. And then I'm going to click Invert. And that means whatever this layer is covering, it's going to mask it out. So if I click the left edge of this shape and drag it out, it's going to cover up my text now. And the last thing I need is I need to be able to animate this rectangle here, and I need the mask to move with it at the same time. And to do that, I'm going to select my mask layer. And then down here, I have some options for responsive design position. And this is going to allow me to pin that mask to the rectangle shape. And if I click in the center here, it means that all of the edges of my mask will move when that rectangle is being moved. So now what I can do is I can go up to my rectangle and I'm going to turn on keyframes for position just by clicking this icon here. And then I'm going to jump forward 1 second in my timeline. And then I'm going to drag that rectangle to the left side of my text. So now we have an animation that looks like this. Which looks great, but I do find that the animation is a little bit abrupt at the very end there. And to make this look a bit smoother, I'm going to select my graphic. I'll go up to my effect controls and I want to twirl open the settings for that shape rectangle. I'll go down to where the position settings are and I'm going to select both of these keyframes here. I'm going to right click them and set them to ease in and then ease out. And now we have something that looks a bit smoother like this. The last thing that I like to add to animations like this is to not only have the rectangle slide in from the right, but also have the text slide in from the left. And to do that, I'll just move my playhead to 1 second in my timeline. I'm going to go and select my text layer in the Essential Graphics panel, and I'll turn on the keyframes for position. And then I'll move to the very start of the sequence, and I'll slightly push that text to the left. And I'll also add an ease in and an ease out for this animation as well to keep it smooth. And then we have something that looks like this. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did, please like and subscribe for more videos like this. Don't forget you can also purchase these motion graphics templates on my website. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.